confidence, confidence, confidence. Probably the number one word you will hear someone say when they're talking about how a person can improve themselves. But I guess I'm going to add to that list. The reason why you lack confidence is because you lack courage. You're scared. What are you scared of? Well, you're afraid of being judged. Judged by who? Others around you. If you were the only person on the planet, you would not be afraid of being judged. It's all relative to people around us. That's one of the laws of relativity. And so, why is it that you lack courage? Well, what is it that you lack courage about? Knowing who you are. And why don't you know who you are? Well, once you know who you are, you'll know to love yourself. You don't know who you are. Therefore, you can't love yourself because you don't know what aspects to love about you. Once you dive deep and know who you are and accept yourself for who you are, those are two key points. Accept yourself for who you are. There's no reason for you to be ashamed or discouraged for others not liking you. I don't need to be liked when I'm already loved. I'm loved by who? By me. There was a point in my time when, because of my illness, it had caused a lot of flare-ups on my skin. It got to the point where I wouldn't even, when I got in the shower, I would only flick one switch on because it wouldn't be as bright and I couldn't see myself in the mirror. That's how much I was self-conscious about myself. It got worse when I was even selling at the time, back in 2021. I was selling grooming products. And the reason why I was self-conscious is because how ironic is it for me, a salesman about grooming products that's meant to help with acne, have all of these complications with myself? How was I able to tell the person, yeah, buy this product? I felt like I lacked credibility, and it was always in the back of my head. I was always thinking, yo, somebody looking at me wrong. The spotlight effect. It's the idea that we think that everyone is watching us, even though the fact of the matter is, nobody really cares. Everybody has their own spotlight effect on themselves. You get it? So, I guess I should talk about how I learned to love myself. Well, first, I spent time alone with myself. You too busy on the internet being distracted, not knowing who you are. You're just an NPC roaming this earth, and you have no idea what you want in this world. You have no idea what you're doing. The number one thing you need to do is eliminate distractions that's diverging your attention from you. All your attention needs to be on how you can better you and how you can get what you want out of life. Confidence cannot come without courage. Courage is you being able to do something in the face of fear. And fear really doesn't even exist. It's really what you create, because you may be fearful of, let's say you may be fearful of getting on a roller coaster, for example. And the reason that you're afraid is because you may fear heights, but and you don't even know why you fear heights. Well, maybe it's obviously because it's a human instinct, maybe not, you know, to be on the ground, but you've never been on a roller coaster before. So there's no reason for you to not know if you'll like it or not. And then you get on the roller coaster, finally, after being convinced by all your friends to do it, maybe you end up doing it and you realize, oh, it wasn't that bad. Oh, let me do it again. And then you want to do it again because you realize, oh, there's nothing. It was all in my head. It was all in your head. It was self-created, and it could be self-managed. You have to constantly be aware of what it is that may make you fearful of the outcome that you want. I know a big thing that people are fearful of is being judged, and that's part of the personally for me, I had that fear a lot too, and especially when I was younger. I've been thinking about doing YouTube since 2017. I held it off, and I used excuses to validate why it wasn't worth it for me to do it. Yeah. even though deep down I kept getting those voices in my head a couple months at a time telling me, yo, go for it, go for it, go for it. And ironically, it's when I have a stage 3 illness and I have even more flare-ups and I have this going on, that going on, more health issues, more complications going on. You could argue the lowest point I've been in my life is when I decided to do it, but it's just, I stopped giving a fuck. You just can't give a fuck. And you just gotta say, man, you know what? Something has to click for you. The desire to change has to be stronger than the desire to remain the same. The self-talk is very important. I had self-limiting beliefs all the time about myself. And then there were moments where I didn't have self-limiting beliefs about myself. But it was a fake confidence that I was exuding. It wasn't real. It wasn't really true to me, because I was only confident because I was an athlete, so I felt validated because I was an athlete. And not only was I an athlete, but I was a good athlete. And I'd always been athletic, and I got all these awards and all type of, I cannot list off all of the awards I've received in my life for different things, poetry or athleticism or debates, anything. And so I felt validated off of those things. But last couple of years, like, life has stripped me of all of those external validators, the muscles or the athleticism or being or telling everybody that you're in college so you don't feel bad for not being in college and being slandered because that's the way the society has worked. All those things was taken away from me, and all that was left was who I was in my core. And the onion was peeled back to the point of no return, and I had to look myself in the mirror, and I had to be able to look myself in the mirror and not just look at myself but have a smile on my face, because I'm happy that I'm the man that I am, and that I know who I am, and that I'm loving who I am, and that I'm loving who I'm becoming, and that I'm able to accept who I am and transform every day and explore deeper aspects of my identity. And once you are able to love yourself, you don't care about anybody's dislike, because your love overrides their hatred for you. And so you're able to go in this world with a sort of aura that people can sense. And it's attractive, and it's like an irresistible aura. I talk about this in my other video about 5 things that make you attractive. And the number one thing is self-love. It is self-love. And self-love breeds confidence. Because you don't care anymore about what people think. You don't care. It takes a long time to get to that point. Everybody has their own different timeline for when they reach it. But it is definitely reachable for every single person in this world. And you don't think that you're the only one who thinks this either. The people that you see every day walking past you on the street, don't think that they're confident and that they have no flaws or no skeletons they hide in a closet. Because deep down, they may even be less confident than you. So they may everyone puts on a mask so that people don't expose their vulnerability, because they could damage them. So just know that when you see people in the streets, or when you interact with people, they have a guard up, and they may be putting off a side of fake confidence, but deep down inside, they may just be a shell of a person with no love for themselves and no aspirations for who they want to be, no self-acceptance for who they are, and no goal towards self-transformation and self-mastery. So don't let that fool you. It's a daily process, and maybe I could create a digital product that may help you get closer to loving yourself. Create some courses or something free. I'm not here just to cash grab or get anything from you. I'm here to actually help you and give you free things too, because I know everybody's trying to, you know, sell something nowadays. Which obviously, it makes sense why they're doing it. Eventually down the line, I'm going to as well. But for right now, like, I'm in nowhere near the stage to give anything for monetary gain. So I want to help you. And so comment down below what it is that has caused you so much fear. Because fear really doesn't exist. Point to fear. You can't. It's all in your head. And so just as you create it, you can destroy it. All it takes is a switch of your mindset. Mindset is the foundation of it. So you love yourself. There's nobody in the world that can stop you from being confident. You have fun with yourself. You're able to laugh at yourself. You're able to be alone. That's another big thing. Being isolated, but knowing that you're never truly alone because you have you. And that's all that's necessary. That's all that's needed. And you are also here in this world for a reason, and that should give you confidence. Like, the fact that you are here in this world is okay. Whatever higher supreme being or almighty one brought me here in this existence for a reason, that should already give you enough confidence to know that, yo, the fact that you are even alive, like, most don't make it. So that should give you confidence to know, like, yo, I'm here for a reason. Like, forget what you think. Like, nobody's gonna care about the conversation that you may have with a person about how they disliked what you did, or you're in an argument with a person that's hating on you. 5 years, or when you're on your deathbed, that's not gonna be something that you think about or recall on about, something that impacted your life. It's not gonna be. It does not matter. It does not matter. Most people that hate on you probably won't even say it to your face for real. It'll just be talking behind your back. And so don't let it get to you. Nobody that's doing better than you will ever hate you. So when you love yourself, you can never be rejected because you don't reject yourself. So remember that. And you have to be a creator of your reality. I'm a believer, and I tell myself that only good things happen to me, that I am a creator of my reality. I don't believe in anything that takes power away from me because I hold all the power. Once you take 100% accountability for your life and your responsibilities and for controlling your self-love and your confidence, you gain all the power. Nobody could take it from you. So hopefully they gave you some more perspective on how you can love yourself. I mean, I can definitely say, just, it's, you can't fake it. Like, you can't fake it. Like, you'll know deep down if you love yourself. Like, you really will. Like, you just have to be alone. That's the number one thing. If you can be alone with yourself and not need anyone to be happy, not need anyone to be fulfilled, like, not rely on anyone for your source of happiness or your source of fulfillment or your source of value, that's when you know that you love yourself. It all starts from within. So, with that being said, until the next one, I want you to seize the day. Think of some things that you can do to love yourself. Incorporate them and do it. It'll massively change your own image, your own self-image, and you'll see a different world. So, seize the day as always. Do what you need to get done to become a better you. And subscribe for more value, like, comment, subscribe, and share. And with that being said, I'm out, man.